All right, LSU fans, welcome back into the LSU Film Room brought to you by Community Coffee. This time in this film session, we're actually going in the Wayback Machine. We're going all the way back to 2002, LSU versus Kentucky. As you can notice, I've got a guy that had a big role in that game, Marcus Randall, the quarterback of the LSU Tigers in that contest, sitting to my left. Imran, did anything special happen in this game? Do you remember?
Oh, man. I think we would like to call something special going on right here, man. Shouldn't have been, but yeah, man, we had a great outing. Obviously, man, we had one of the greatest plays that I have been a part of.
All right, now this is a big play because after you get the penalty, you back up 5 yards, and you pick up a chunk of yards here. You get all the way down from the 8-yard line down to the 26-yard line. It sets up the last play. So kind of walk us through this play and kind of what your call was.
Well, we actually have plays that we had for these situations that Coach Jimbo Fisher used to always have us run on every Thursday. We'll have plays where if we didn't think we were frail enough to take the shot yet, that we would have these plays designed where either we'll have trips to the side and we have both inside guys run on go routes and we have the outside receiver come, as you saw Michael Clayton there, but we also had it the other way around with the outside receiver. They would run go routes and we'll have the inside receiver run a 15-yard out route. So we chose to go with Michael Clayton, that one of our big play guy. Knew we had a timeout, so we didn't need to get to the sideline. Right. So we ended up running the play. We knew they were going to leave the middle of the field open for us to get a big chunk of yards.
All right, so here it is. We've got 2 seconds left in the contest. You're on the 25-yard line. We know the play, dash right, 93 Berlin. I don't know how many times we ran this play at practice. It might have been 100. I mean, it was every Thursday, Friday, right. we practice this play. Right. You never believe you're going to get in this situation, though, right, with a chance to win the game.
Correct.
Like, it's your last-ditch effort. Hey, if we get in the situation, here's what we're going to call. But a lot of times in those type of plays, like, you never actually get a chance to run them in the game. So how many times do you think you ran dash right 93 Berlin?
This may have been the only time I think I've ever ran it since I've been here.
Exactly. Right. But in practice, how many times?
But we practiced it. If I was here 5 years, and we practiced it every Thursday. So, I mean, how many weeks is that? I mean, that's a lot of preparing for a situation that you barely ever get in. So, but having to be prepared for these type of situations, and even when we ran it in practice, it pretty much never worked. I mean, it would always get batted down. You know, Corey Webster, Travis James, them would be knocking it down.
You have all those situations pop up, and as a quarterback, you're thinking, wait a minute, man, I got to try to throw the ball 80 yards. We got the wind howling here in the stadium. I mean, so many different things against you. They're rushing 3, dropping 8.
Correct.
I mean, they've got guys near the goal line here in prevent defense. And so everything has to go just perfectly right for you to pull off this play. And, you know, luckily for LSU, it did go that way. And so kind of walk us through, though, the mechanics of what these receivers are supposed to do, because it's not just, hey, we're going to throw it to you, you catch and run the end zone. There's actually a purpose for what Michael Clayton's trying to do here.
Correct. I mean, he was always our, biggest receiver, highest jumper, so he was always the tip guy, so he was always the aiming point for him to get up and pretty much do what he did. People say he might have tipped, he might have not, but that was the plan for him to get up high as he could, try to make the tip, and we normally, like I say, this normally be in the end zone, though. And we normally have one of our guys, you know, ready to make the catch behind him, just like you can see Debbie doing right here.
Yeah, so typically, like you mentioned, like, this ball is usually in the end zone because
Correct.
You're not, you know, 75 yards away when you're trying to have a last-second play for the win here. And so dash right is a rollout to the right for the quarterback.
Correct.
And it's also kind of like you're setting the edge, as we see the back doing here, right? Don't
Correct.
Allow this guy.
Don't
93 also
side.
Is the protection in Berlin. It's kind of the concept, right?
And so it comes from the wall, Berlin. You know, that's why it's just a bomb. We're throwing a bomb play as a Hail Mary. So that's where we get the Berlin call from.
All right, so you roll to your right, you stop, and you literally, as you can see, we got a little hitch, a little crow hop, almost baseball outfielder style, and you just let it rip.
Correct. And you're talking about the wind, as you can see the ball kind of tailing in the air as it's going.
Look, the ball starts
right.
It about starts over here. 3 yards outside of the right hash, and where it ends up is about right on that hash.
Correct.
I mean, you can definitely see it moving big time. It almost, look, at the very end, it's going all the way left, and it stops and goes back right. I mean, it switches
right.
a couple times in the air. And I told you, Imran, before we started to record, the fact that I've never seen this end zone copy, it even gives me more of an appreciation for this play. I had no idea. The football, after it's tipped, it's like a helicopter.
Correct.
I mean, it is spinning so fast like a helicopter. I don't know how in the world Devery Henderson was able to catch this football. The concentration to not only catch this ball, but he actually tips it to himself.
Tipped it to himself.
So many things could have gone wrong here. Correct. But the concentration, and probably why the guy played a decade in the NFL,
correct,
to catch this football, I just hope people realize how difficult that is.
And, man, yeah, this is my first time seeing it actually spin like that. Like I said, I've seen it, but I haven't seen this copy maybe since 2002.
Well, you threw it so far, you couldn't see from right, where you threw it from.
And you hear people talk about luck so much, and then when, you know, my definition of luck is when preparation meets opportunity. And like you say, man, we prepared for this for years, and this was just the opportunity for us to use it. And it worked just like, as you see, nobody really gave up. If you look at the offensive line, everybody's still going through their blocking protection, even though it looked far-fetched for us to win this game. And we're not in the perfect situation to even run the play that we're right, running. So you see everybody's still doing their 111. Everybody's still going hard. All the receivers still going to the ball like they're supposed to. Nobody giving up on the play. And great things happen.
Absolutely. Dash right, 93 Berlin, a play that will live in the history books for LSU football forever. We'll see you next time. Go Tigers.